Making music is intelligence in action. Let me say that again. Making music is intelligence in action. Playing a musical instrument requires an intricate combination of intellectual, visual, physical, and auditory responses, coupled with a perceptive decision-making progress. A musician's mind is synchronized with other musicians in an ensemble, creating musical moments by manipulating melodic, harmonic, and rhythmic sounds as individuals and as a collective entity. Now that's the really up-scientific way of thinking about all the great music you're about to hear tonight, but each day I get to hear that in working with students. My name is David Orhowski. I'm a middle school band director at Penfield and department chair for instrumental music. It's a pleasure to welcome you all this evening. And each day as we work with these students, we see the following things happen, but you're now going to get to see them happen simultaneously on this stage. Because while reading and playing an instrument, a musician's brain is performing multiple tasks all at once. Reading symbols, translating Italian musical terms, interpreting this information into fingerings, stickings, and sounds. Manipulating airspeed and embouchure control. Listening to other musicians in an effort to match pitch, phrasing, dynamic level, articulation, and tone quality. Performing musical literature, following the conductor, and analyzing the performance while you perform. And performing on a stage in front of you all, developing the confidence to do exactly that and do it in public in front of a live audience. And again, doing each one of these things simultaneously. In fact, I'm challenged to think of any other place in the middle of a student day anywhere where they are challenged to do that many things at once. That's what it takes to make the great music we get to hear. And as these students do that for us tonight, they don't do it alone, obviously. They do it with a great support system. And we thank you, family members, certainly especially parents, along with friends, administrators, teachers, for all of the effort and support and the time that you give our outstanding musicians. And of course, to all the musicians in our music program. Tonight's wind ensembles, they're each groups that students audition to be members of at the middle school level and of course at the high school level as well. We're proud of their talent, their music, and their extra effort, but we also recognize and never forget that this all begins in their music classrooms at the elementary level, throughout the secondary level, and continuing as they work hard in their performance classes each day with us, and we're very proud of their efforts. So tonight we'll have four performing groups and we'll have three middle school groups and of course the high school wind ensemble. And we're gonna start with the Penbrook Wind Ensemble. They're gonna have two selections for you. The first is called Intrepid Journey by Robert Sheldon. It's a musical tribute to the Core and Discovery Expedition regarding a Louisiana Purchase by Lewis and Clark, intended to honor the bravery and incredible fortitude of the explorers who left from St. Louis in 1804 and reached the Pacific Ocean in 1806, facing incredible challenges and danger along the way. And their second selection is called Equilibrium. The word itself is defined as a state in which opposing forces or actions are balanced so that one is not stronger than the other. And this piece walks a musical tightrope toward achieving such balance, using the center point of the octave, the tritone as a melodic and harmonic motive. Equilibrium constantly pits opposing elements against each other to achieve or disrupt a balanced musical state. Rhythmic and harmonic transformation, shifting meters, the constant interplay between the winds and percussion, and a constant driving pulse propel the piece towards its own musical equilibrium. It's my pleasure at this time to introduce the Penbrook Wind Ensemble under the direction of Mr. James Markopol. Thank you.
Thank you.
It's time for our second performing group from Penfield, our Penfield Middle School Wind Ensemble. They have a particularly special spring coming up because they're gearing up for the first ever performance of the Penfield Wind Ensemble at our Pennsylvania Music Educators Association conference. It occurs annually. This year it's in Hershey, and we're very proud to know that they're heading out there representing us. We actually have four performing groups in North Penn School District performing there this year, so we are always proud of our groups that are selected by audition to participate and represent some of the great music education we have here in our district. They have two selections, and it's hard to have a performance in one evening of bands and not have a Susan March. So it's great to have a Susan March. This one is the Gladiator March. And the second selection they're going to do is a great selection they've really been enjoying working on called Mount Everest, and that's by Rossano Galante. We will now be happy to introduce, under the direction of Mr. Christopher Thompson, the Penfield Wind Ensemble. Thank you. And it's time for our third act, if you will. We have the Pendale Middle School, and they have two selections they're going to do. I'm going to read a bit about the first one. It's called Chasing the Storm, and it is an energetic representation of a stormy night filled with thunder, lightning, rain, wind, and tornadoes. Its driving rhythms and almost constant forward motion depict the tension that is created by such a storm as one waits for it to end. Most people take shelter, but there are some who have the job of keeping up with the storm and have to venture out into it so they can warn others about dangers. Listen as you hear the storm passing over your head. Hopefully no blizzards, obviously, just that kind of storm. And their second selection is called Bugler's Holiday, and it is my pleasure to introduce, under the direction of Mr. Ted Heller, the Pendale Wind Ensemble.
Thank you. Okay. Here we go. Welcome again to North Penn High School and our Night of Wind Ensembles. So there's a story I have to tell you about why we're doing this. Mr. Kennedy, you're all by yourself. It's supposed to be a trio. Come on out. Come on out. So 3 years ago, I did this with the Wind Ensemble, only because I had two outstanding trumpet players in my ninth grade here at Penndale, and this year I thought it's time to bring them back because they're seniors, and I want to recognize their accomplishments. And then word got out to the music staff. I'm about to tell you, for years, I'm going to give you the answer. For years I've been getting this question. Why is the North Penn High School, actually, why is the North Penn School District Music Department so fantastic? Why is the music department so amazing? Ladies and gentlemen, look in front of you. There's your answer. They're all trumpet players. Take a quick moment here. Let me introduce you to, this is Mr. Britcher, high school band director, trumpet player extraordinaire. Father of two. This is Mr. Malachowski, extraordinary trumpet player, elementary music teacher, father of two. This is Mr. Bob Kennedy, has the pleasure of being my assistant at Penndale. Just kidding, we work together. Father of three. This is Josh Weckerly, better not be a father. But recently, let me tell you a quick story. Josh just finished district band, and he was first chair at district band. He's going on, we're assuming he'll be first chair at Regents and first chair at All States. Where are you going to college? Temple?
No. I don't know. It's on my list.
It's on the list. I don't know if that's a good thing. Where do you want to go? Temple?
Pass.
You can't pass. It's a live show. Mr. New, who's been around teaching since I was a student here, trumpet player extraordinaire, father of two wonderful children. This is, what's your name again? This is Mr. Orachowski, an amazing trumpet player, also a band director at Penfield, father of two. Do you know him? There's not a lot of love out there for Mr. Orachowski. Father of two wonderful children.
Hey.
This is Mr. DiValentino, amazing trumpet player. But he's not a father, are you?
Not yet.
Not yet. Ladies and gentlemen, when's she due?
April 5th.
April 5th. Is that me? Congratulations, thank you very much. And here comes Josh Faye, another senior trumpet player who is proud, I'm saying, to going. He is going to Temple, is that right?
Pass.
Anyway, I just got an email from the jazz band director, Mr. DiValentino, and this young man has just been seated as lead trumpet in the All-State Jazz Band this year, so congratulations. Once word got out that they were joining us, there was a couple of other people. And I want to welcome Mr. Markipol. Stand up, Mr. Markipol. Give us a little shout out, Mr. Markipol. Mr. Thompson is over here as well. Mr. Thompson. Mrs. Ware is in the house. She says, can I please play? I said, all right, come play with us. But Mrs. Ware. Finally, one of whenever we are out at district band, region band, Bucksmar band, whatever it is, we have an amazing substitute teacher that comes in, never gets the opportunity to conduct, and this is his opportunity. So please welcome our conductor for Bugler's Holiday. Even though he's a Salerton grad, he wanted to be a North Penn grad, but this is Mr. Tom Morris conducting Bugler's Holiday. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
If you would please just bear with us one second. We've always talked about having all these trumpet players, but we've actually never played together, so we need to document this. Bear with us one second. We're taking a picture.
We now come to our final performing group of the evening, and that, of course, is the High School Wind Ensemble. And they have three pieces they're going to do for us this evening, but I'm going to take the time to introduce each piece as we go along through the evening. Their first one is called Wind Sprints, written by Richard Saucedo. He spent his career serving as the Director of Bands and Performing Arts Department Chair at Carmel High School in Indiana. We were fortunate to have him here in our district observing our program in the spring of 2014. We opened the program with one of his compositions on which Saucedo writes, "Wind Sprints is a flourish of notes and rhythms meant to stir the kind of emotion one might experience during the running of a 50 or 100 yard dash." The piece gets off the starting blocks quickly and immediately involves numerous wind and percussion instruments in a technical race to the finish. Under the direction of Mr. Michael Britcher, the North Penn High School Wind Ensemble. The second selection is called Redwood. Composer Ryan George writes the following on his composition. When the Collins High School Band in Sewanee, Georgia, approached me about writing a piece for their head band director, who was set to retire at the end of the year, they wanted something that spoke not only to this man's love of music, but also to his love for the great outdoors. I was reminded then of the times growing up when my family and I would go camping at Sequoia National Park, and we would set up our tents among the giant redwood trees that grow in that region of California. These trees command attention with their immense stature, their size, the result of years gone by and storms weathered, and yet they exude a peaceful and subtle tranquility. This idea of powerful tranquility became the cornerstone for this lyrical tone poem. Redwood was commissioned by the Collins Hill High School Band in 2010 and written in honor of Richard Marshall.
Thank you.
And the third selection, Give Us This Day, concludes our performance this evening with an epic composition. The composer gives the listener the following insight into the work completed in 2005. The words, Give Us This Day, are of course from the Lord's Prayer, but the inspiration for this music is Buddhist. I have recently read a book by the Vietnamese Buddhist monk Thich Nhat Hanh entitled For a Future to be Possible. His premise is that a future for the planet is only possible if individuals become deeply mindful of themselves, deeply connected to who they really are. While this is not a new idea and something that is an ongoing struggle for everyone, in my estimation, it is the issue for world peace. For me, writing music and working with people to perform music are two of those points of deep mindfulness. Music makes the connection to reality, and by reality, I mean a true awakeness and awareness. Give Us This Day gives us this very moment of awakeness and aware aliveness so that we can build a future in the face of a most dangerous and difficult time. Give us this day. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of all our directors this evening, Mr. Britcher, Mr. Mark Capole, Mr. Thompson, Mr. Heller, along with all our performers, we thank you. And gee, let's give it up one more time for all of this evening's performers, Penndale, Penfield, Pembroke, and North Penn High School. Have a great evening.